Hello everyone, welcome to the quick mask exercise of our Photoshop clinic. We are going to start with our armamandite JPEG. Bring that down, open that up in Photoshop. And what we want to do here is we want to cut out this armor guy from the photo. There are a couple ways to do this. You could use the eraser tool and erase around him. You could use the marquee tool and get a real rough cut. You could use the magic wand, but today we're going to practice the quick mask. It's down here on the bottom of the toolbar. Click that. Also, Q will activate and deactivate. Before we get started, you can double click on it. It gives us a couple options about customizing it. If we're working on a red image, we can change the color we're using, but we're not really. We don't need to worry about that right now. And we don't need to worry about this option either. I'll show you what that is in just a minute. Hit OK. So let's get started. Let's enter quick mask mode. Here we are in quick mask mode. Here we are now. Let's grab our paintbrush. And what quick mask allows us to do, it allows us to paint on our selection. In red here, anything that is red will be selected. So what we can do is we can paint the outline of our little armor guy instead of having to do all the hard work and getting a rough cut. This is very accurate, but it does take some time. You can hold the space bar down to move the canvas. Click and bring up the hand tool so you can keep your work centered. Now, the advantage of Quick Mask is it allows for a lot of options and editability. Say I go off the edge here. Whoops. Now, there's a couple ways we can handle that. And then down here in your palette, you can switch the colors. That's X, if you want to learn the keyboard shortcuts. And you can just paint white right over that. What that does is that deselects everything. Hit X again, or switch the colors back to black. And we can start filling it in again. There's no need to be super precise here, because we can always come back and clean it up. Which is what I'm going to have to do. Now you can right-click and choose a bigger brush, or you can also get these options up here in the toolbar menu. Let's give it a nice big brush here. Start coming in, filling in some of these details. Now you notice that we're getting a real hard edge, even though we're using the brush tool. That's all adjustable here under hardness. If you want to give it a little bit of a softer edge, you can lower. It gives it a real soft brush. And bring it up right about 90%, I believe, will work very well for what we're trying to do here, because these edges aren't actually hard, they're soft. Switch colors, start taking away some of these errors. Now if you exit Quick Mask, zoom out, Command minus, or option, or control minus, I mean, on a PC. Let's see what we have so far. We have, it's not too bad. Back in Quickmask. It's always good to take a step back and look at what you're doing. So I think we have this mostly filled in. What we're going to do is we're going to cheat a little bit. We're going to select the paint bucket. And we're just going to fill it all in with black. And get some of these details here that using a soft brush missed. Perfect. Let's exit Quickmask mode, see what we have so far. Not too bad. Let's get back into Quickmask mode and just touch it up just a little bit here. Use your brush tool. Clean that up. Didn't get any of this, so let's clean that up. Sometimes you might have to choose a smaller brush to get some of these real big details. And this is where you want to take your time, because the more accurate of a selection you have, the easier you're going to have in blending this object when you want to use it somewhere else. Easy fix. I'm just painting out all these details here, switching between X, switching by hitting X rather, between black and white, painting in all these last little bits. Sometimes some of these make you zoom in real close. Alright, take one final scan. Not too bad. All the areas we want are black. All the areas we want, rather, are red by painting black over them. A couple touch ups here. Like I said, always good to take a step back. Alright, now if we exit Quickmask mode, hit Q or the button down here. Now remember that option I told you about? in the beginning. Color indicates masked areas versus selected areas. Of course, I had it backwards. That's all right. Very easy fix. So you'll see our selection is inverted. So let's re-invert it. Select, inverse. There we go. That's exactly what we want. Perfect. Now we're going to save the selection. Select, save selection. Let's call it arm man. Hit OK. Perfect. Now under the channels tab, you'll see our armor guy ready to use. We can call up the selection again. Select, load selection, armor man. Okay, here he is. That is how you successfully use the quick mask mode to pick out elements of a picture. And next lesson, we're going to teach you what to do with this.